Hi, my name's Jared, and in this bootcamp, we're going to be going over liquid universe selection. Universe selection is when you apply an algorithm to select stocks which you want to trade, rather than choosing stocks arbitrarily. This is to avoid something called selection bias. It's often common to only select stocks which still exist. By using an algorithm to select stocks based on a rule, you can get a true snapshot of the market, and that will include stocks which have historically been delisted. Commonly, you only remember stocks which are still trading. And so by using universe selection, it gets around this human bias and allows us to have a true understanding of how our algorithm is performing on a wide selection of stocks. So we do this with something in QuantConnect called coarse fundamental data, and you're going to learn about the coarse fundamental object. We're going to use this array of thousands and thousands of stocks and then filter it down based on the volume of each one and then select the highest volume stocks for trading. So to get started, let's click the first task. The first task, we need to ask for a universe and pass in the filter function we want to use for that universe. So first here, we need to set up an empty filter function. And then save the value of the coarse object. Every day, QuantConnect passes in the list of the currently trading securities into this coarse object, and here we're going to save it to a class variable. This list is approximately 8,000 stocks long. Now the second part is to return an unchanged universe. When you return the universe.unchanged property, it signals to QuantConnect that you don't want to make any changes to the universe and to continue running. Now finally, we need to actually ask for the universe and pass in our filter function. So here you can see we've added universe and then we've given it our coarse selection filter, which is this one here. And so it's going to be ideally performing some filtering and selection on that and then returning it. Let's see how we go. Okay, great. On to the next task. Now we're going to be building our coarse selection filter. Every day, 8,000 objects get passed in here as a list. We need to use that list and select down to the ones that we actually want in our algorithm. So the first part says to sort descending by dollar volume. Here we can just use a simple Python sort function. And so you can see here the sorted function takes our list, looks through every coarse object at the dollar volume property of that object, and then reverse sorts it, which means it takes the highest volume at the top and then descends. So next, we want to make sure we're only trading stocks with a price of more than $10 per share. So we can apply that with a filter. So you can see our filter here. We go through every one of our sorted assets and we extract the symbol and we check if its price is more than $5. The objective says we need more than 10, so let's tweak this one. And then finally, we need to only return the most 8 liquid stocks. So we can do that by slicing the array. Here we want to take the top 8. And then finally, we return this as our list. So if you notice here, in the beginning, this is a sorted coarse fundamental object list. And then here, when we do c.symbol, we're actually extracting the symbol object and putting it into this array. And then finally, we're taking a slice of the top 8 symbols and returning them. In QuantConnect, the symbol is the universal way of identifying a security. It contains all of the information necessary to uniquely identify a trading asset, a trading company at a point in time. So by selecting the symbols, we've got a backwards compatible way that we can identify a company in the past without any sort of bias. So let's submit our answer and see how we go. There are a few different properties here on the coarse fundamental object, the dollar volume and price, and this is really intended as a coarse filter. It's a first pass filter on the 8,000 securities. to get down to the core ones that you'd like to analyze in further detail. Okay, great. On to the next task. When we're performing a universe selection, we don't know what securities are going to be added to our algorithm. So we need to use the onSecuritiesChanged event handler to analyze those securities which get added and removed, and then act accordingly for our algorithm. So here, we need to create this onSecuritiesChanged event handler. And then all of the changes in the universe will be passed into this function. So the objective is saying that we need to log this. And save the value. Let's see how we go. It's common to use this event handler to say set up your indicators for each security or do any sort of history calls to prepare it. Okay, great. On to the next task. Now, finally, we're in our onSecuritiesChanged function. We know which securities have been added to our algorithm. Now we need to trade on them. So in this case, we're actually just going to assign an equal weighting of our portfolio to the securities which have been selected by our universe. As we've noted in the past tutorials, you need to make sure you liquidate or downsize your positions before you upsize other ones. So let's first iterate over our security changes to liquidate anything which has been removed. These security removals are located here under the remove securities list. And so you can just loop over them and then call the liquidate function to exit out. Okay, so we're saying for every security in our remove securities list, liquidate them. And now we've freed up some buying power. Let's go and buy the other ones. And it's asking us to allocate 10% of our portfolio to each one. So set holdings is a fraction of your buying power. So if 10% is 0.1. So now for every security and added securities, set holdings 0.1. Okay. Okay, you can already see here that we're doing some trading. So that means our set holdings has worked and we've completed the task and on to the next one. Okay, great. So when you add a security with universe selection, you don't get the same control that you do with manual selection where you add the leverage and the resolution security by security. So to handle that, QuantConnect has something called universe settings. So these are default settings that will be applied to every item which is added from these core selection universes. So you can see here that we have universe settings.resolution, leverage, fill forward. And so this means what is the resolution of the assets which are getting added to the universe. In the same way here, we have this minimum time in universe property. So if your asset gets added and removed from a universe too quickly, you can set it here so that it stays in the universe for a minimum period of time, and then whether or not you want extended market hours. Okay, so the task for this one is we need to change the universe settings with the leverage to be 2. And then with that increased leverage that we've allocated each item, let's increase our allocation to 18%. So if we go here, self.universe settings. Now we need to do set holdings for every item, 0.18. So if you notice here, it's allocating 0.18, which isn't quite a perfect double of the previous. So this is because we've left intentionally a small buffer of cash. If you allocate your positions too tightly, it can sometimes result in trade errors, especially with daily data. Overnight, the prices might move, And so you might not be able to fill the trades as you'd like because you've allocated your cash too tightly. So in this case, we're going to assign 0.18 times 10. So it's 180% of our portfolio and pretty close to our 2 leverage. Let's see how it goes. We'll submit that. Okay, great. Congratulations, you've just completed the Liquid Universe Selection tutorial. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.